Colin Skidmore this morning from Stelar Metals. Colin, good morning.
Good morning, Andrew.
Colin, look, since you and I last spoke, a bit of a refocus and strategy, if you like, here to focus on lithium. Tell us a bit more about the plans going forward.
Sure. So, our company hadn't had lithium in the portfolio, in part because our chairman, Steve Biggins, was still the managing director of Core Lithium. He resigned from that position, and Stephen and I used to work at Core, and I was actually the first geologist on the ground at the Finniss Project, for which Core Lithium then took forward to production. So I went there and did the due diligence. But now he left, we decided that certainly lithium is probably the best thing that we could have in our portfolio of strategic mineral projects. And so I embarked upon having a look around. Now, I used to be a Broken Hill geologist, and just remember, there were pegmatites everywhere in the Broken Hill block. And recognize that the Urawi part in the northern section, which was an old tin mining area, has potential to be very prospective for lithium. In fact, it looks very, very similar stage to those projects in the Northern Territory that I went up and looked at in 2016 for Core. So we decided that we would try to get hold of this, and we did a joint venture with Everest Metals to pick up quite a large portfolio of tenements up there, which included this Trident lithium project.
Well, tell us a bit more. What do we know as far as the lithium prospectivity here, given the previous exploration?
Okay, so very little previous exploration, of course. So back in the 1800s, there were mining, 1900s rather, oh, no, 1800s even, there were mining for tin and eventually tantalum. Back in the 1950s, for a very short period of time, they actually started mining some lithium as aligninite, which is a lithium phosphate mineral, probably only about 30 tons. And it's probably about the only known lithium occurrences which have ever been mined in New South Wales. The thing, the mineral that you really want when you're looking for lithium, the economic one, is spodumene. Now, spodumene doesn't tend to last on the surface. It weathers very quickly to a smectite clay, and the lithium just washes down the creek. This is exactly what we saw when we went up to the Northern Territory. It wasn't until you started drilling that you found the spodumene at depth, only about 50 meters down there. This area has never really been drilled. Carpentaria had it. They were looking for tin. They did some drilling at a pegmatite, but a long way away from where the lithium's actually known. The only company that really did any lithium exploration was Lepidico back in 2016. They did some rock chip sampling, and they recognized aligninite and lepidolite. These are lithium minerals at surface. They came back with large, broad lithium, cesium, tantalum anomalies. Some of these pegmatites extend for a kilometer, hundreds of meters wide. And to say, there's no drilling. So no one's ever had a chance to have a look to see for the spodumene potential at depth, just the same as we saw when we went up to the Northern Territory.
So what are your plans, Colin, for the project?
So at the moment, we are negotiating with landholders, stakeholders, engaging with everyone. We've only had this for a few weeks now. We would like to, we believe that you need to get in there early and drill. So I will hopefully come Q3 this year, put in a small RC program just to have a look at the orientation, the morphology of these pegmatites, and have a look for that spodumene potential. They are folded, they're deformed, they pinch, they swell. There's big bits, there's little bits. We need to make sure that when we go in for a proper drill program, we know exactly where we are and that we're targeting the right place. And to assist with this, we recently, as per announcement this week, we come to an arrangement with SensOre, who, as part of the New South Wales government strategy for high-tech metals, is going to use Trident as the test bed to have a look at these pegmatites to see for methods to determine the best parts of pegmatites using geochemistry and geophysics. So we're really pleased to be part of that. There's no cost to our company, but you know, it's really important that these things are found, and we work these along for the great benefit of New South Wales.
I suppose, Colin, just given some of the recent softening in the lithium price, what's your outlook?
Fundamentals don't really change. Battery technology is ever evolving. I was reading, I think yesterday in the news, about solid state technologies, get away from the electrolytes, which can possibly catch fire. Sodium, yep, yeah, sure, some cars are going to use it, but they only have short range. Now, that's probably not what's really required. I don't think lithium's going away. Technology needs, and the world needs, electrification, and lithium, being number three on the periodic table, stands out as the prime mineral that is good for batteries. So I think for the next many decades, lithium has got a very important part in there.
Good to speak, Colin. Thanks for your time.
Thank you very much, Andrew. Thank you.